watching rock and roll all night.
Turn it up and go get laid.
I want to rock and roll all night!
Jack Rabbit from Union. Check it out.
Thanks.
No. I am watching rock and roll all night.
Hi, it's Brent Fitz. You're watching rock and roll all night. And
I'm Bill O'Coin, and I watch rock and roll all night.
Hey, it's Kevin Conrad. You're watching rock and roll all night.
John Regan from Fraley's Comet, and you're watching rock and roll all night. Don't tune out.
And you're watching rock and roll all night.
Thank you.
This is Andre Augustine, Guardian of the Gods. You're watching rock and roll all night.
I'm Mark St. John. You're watching rock and roll all night. Yep.
All right, welcome to Rock and Roll on Hype. Going to have a little round table talking about the KISS merchandise.
And there's a lot of it, yeah.
And there's a lot of it,
today
yes.
We'll talk about the merchandise.
Mm-hmm.
Upcoming next is Wheel of News.
Brought some
right.
Stuff.
And Chris has got news about Union.
Yeah, you guys know Union, right? Everybody knows Union.
Yeah.
I'm in Union.
Yeah, me too.
Just kidding.
Union was on tour, but as we talked about last time, they ended their tour, and they're going to start up now, I hear, in August. I was talking to Brent Fitz, who is the drummer for Union, I did a little interview with him over the telephone, and I have just some of the questions and answers here. I'll just read just a couple of them. Union has put together an excellent CD. All the songs are great. This will probably be tough. But what is your favorite track on the CD? That was my question to him. What is his favorite track?
Yeah.
And his favorite track, this is his answer here. I don't have a favorite track. I like them all. Although I have strong feelings towards Old Man Wise, because it was the very first song that Bruce, John, and he worked on. So that's his favorite track. I asked him, how do they go pick songs, and what is their process
right.
for the set list for the tour? And he basically said, I won't read the complete answer, but basically he said that they wanted to work out all the songs from the album, and two KISS songs and one from John Corabi's earlier bands. And he said they wanted to work that together, so they knew that it was going to be the majority of the album. And I think they only left out one song.
Oh.
And he said the only reason they left that song out is because they had to go with, if he felt John, who's lead vocalist, Corabi, thought his voice would be strong enough to add these songs in that particular one, because it's a very powerful song, and he didn't know if he could add it with all the rest.
Oh, yeah.
They wanted to play everything, so there was really no process right at this point. They wanted to play everything from the album, and that was pretty much his answer.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
it was pretty tough to go on for your first tour with one album.
Yeah. Yeah. So they do the whole
shows were like 90-minute shows.
Yeah.
Yeah, 90 minutes. They do their whole album except one
That's
song.
Pretty good
right.
For like
they did Jungle,
well, you know,
from
right.
Carnival of Souls.
Most bands play an hour.
They well, did, that's good. At least somebody's playing.
They did
Jungle.
I Walk Alone, which is on Carnival of Souls, and they did acoustic version of Beth.
Ah.
So it's a show to definitely go check out.
Yeah, especially acoustic Beth.
But he said, I asked him, when would you
I
say...
I mean, KISS has been beating that over their head for years.
Yeah.
Gary was good for the early 80s. They didn't do it for a long time.
Yeah.
No. I mean, Beth is a good song, but geez.
Well, this is cool because they do it acoustic, and everyone comes out and jams
on
acoustics. I asked him, when would he say that Union would be back on the road? And He says August. There's no details yet, but we're looking at the end of August is when they're going to start back up. So we'll be seeing them around this area around that time.
Oh, yeah.
There's a couple other questions, but I think that pretty much, you know, I guess he was introduced. I'll just say he was introduced to Bruce Kulick by Lenita Erickson, who Bruce went on tour with her when he was on hiatus from Kiss right before the reunion tour in Germany and Switzerland and stuff like that. And then when they came back, he was introduced. That's how this guy got into the band. And when they did initial recording or initial practice for the Union band, this guy didn't have his drum kit with him. Brent Fitz didn't have his drum kit, so he ended up borrowing one from Eric Singer. Eric Singer lent the drum kit to John Corabi, Bruce Kulick, and Brent Fitz to just, you know, do demos and stuff with. So it's kind of ironic he was using Eric Singer's drum kit. I thought I'd mention that. That was a good question. I had heard that, and I asked him, and he confirmed that that's what happened. So that's pretty much it with that. Brent Fitz, he's an excellent guy. You know, I never met him before, never talked to him before.
Right.
I said, hey, can I do an interview with you, you know, for a show? And he said, hey, no problem.
So, that's good.
You know, these guys are great. They're not big heads. I mean, you've met Bruce Kulick.
Right.
I met Bruce Kulick.
Bruce is more than happy to do the interview.
Oh, yeah, so they're great guys, you know. And they put on a good show. I've heard one of their shows on audio. And it's really, really cool to hear those tunes live.
They do a really good version of Jungle. I was surprised when I heard that. I was like, wow, this is good, you know.
Mm-hmm. So. I've been in contact with the record company, Union's record company, and they're going to be sending me some live clips from their tour. So your show will be the first show to show live Union clips. We'll be getting that very soon.
So, I was thinking of doing that with Mercury.
Yeah, but you'll never get it. They'll never do it.
It doesn't hurt to try.
Right.
Union did cancel their tour, but they have a show coming up July 9th. It's in Los Angeles, obviously. Not many of us will be able to go, but it's a show. It's like a benefit show. A whole bunch of bands are going to be there, and it's in honor of the late West Arkeen. Jamie Hunting, who plays for Union, he's a bass player, played on one of the guy's albums. So it's going to be a cool show, you know, get down there. There's going to be a couple other bands, and I just thought I'd mention that's July 9th, if anyone's out there at the time, which I'm sure that that's not the case, but I just figured I'd report it anyway.
That's right.
Can I remind people out there what's coming up, too? As far as you, Richie Scarlett fans, July 10th at the Alternative Route in Weymouth, Mass. He'll be there with Sebastian Bach again, so that's really cool. He's doing a lot of work with Sebastian Bach, trying to get Sebastian Bach's latest debut album out. I'm definitely going to go.
That's in Connecticut. It's an hour and a half maybe.
Yeah.
So anyone who wants to meet him. And he's always out right after the show. He goes and sits down at the bar. So you always walk up to him, get an autograph, talk to him. Hey, he talks to you, answers any of your questions. He's a great guy, too. Real quick, Union was in Hit Parader magazine this month's issue, the July 98 issue. And it's just basically they do, and there's a section in Hit Parader called Celebrity Rate a Video. And there's not really a picture to see, so you don't have to zoom up on it, but they just rate a video, and the videos, rock videos, like they'll watch MTV and then say what they think of the thing. So if you're interested in to hear anything from Bruce Kulick and John Corabi, the latest stuff, there's a little article in Hit Parader. And they're also in the Metal Edge, and that's the September issue. They're in Metal Edge, and they they just do a live report about it. And they mention how Gene and Paul and Ace showed up at their second show, Union's second show. And that's pretty much my Union news.
Cool.
So
then we can go to this other clip, Union, Pain Behind Your Eyes.
Yes, please, we could play that. Pain Behind Your Eyes.
Okay, so here's Pain Behind Your Eyes.
I hate when that happens.
Another
Your eyes.
Yeah, which is sounds really good. But I don't know what you want to get into next. That was pretty much the union update.
Yeah. See, Paulie just said, this is the second part of, if you got the action figures, the second set, you'll get
little albums.
Little albums.
With the Paul and every
figure. It looks like the solo album.
A different album thing.
You pull it out, there's actually an album in there.
And then you get a little record.
You can't play it.
You can't play it, or it'd be on the world's smallest record player. Probably lasts enough for a 30-minute lunch.
Actually, that opens up real quick if you wanted to. Just pull the paper right out.